Today I want to share a book with you that has a whole bunch of easy quilt projects in it, but really interesting ones as well. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst at Chatterbox Quilts, and the book I want to share with you today is called Quick and Easy Quilts, 20 Machine Quilting Projects by Lynn Goldsworthy, and it's published by the Totten Press. Now, why I like this book is because it has a wide variety of quilts in it. There's quilts that are just piece, there are quilts that have appliqué in them. Of course, you know I love appliqué. But they're all fairly easy to make. They don't look simple, and they don't look super complicated. They just look like really nice quilts. And it's not a new book, but, you know, it doesn't have to be new to be good, right? Let's take a look. So like I said, there's a lot of different techniques being used in this book, from regular piecing to foundation piecing to applique work as well. And so she talks about different information at the front that you're going to need to use. Imperial or metric, I thought that was interesting at the first because here in Canada we use metric, but when it comes to quilting, we buy in meters, but we talk about quilting in yards and inches. So we have a both going on here. But she takes you through basically your general quilting information and how she likes to do things. So that's always helpful to take a look at because you never know when you might learn something new. And then you get into the quilt project. So the first one is called Into the Light Quilt. Now I like bright colors, so this one really caught my eye. Again, you can see it's not a really difficult pattern, but the fabrics that you use in it can make it really pop and look really interesting. So this particular one here is going to be foundation paper piece. Now, I wouldn't have thought that when I first looked at it, and there's other ways you can make this, but that's what she's using for this particular quilt called Into the Light. So she takes you through the cutting, making the blocks, assembling the quilt, and she also has different diagrams or photos, of course, of the whole quilt, which is always nice to see. But she also tells you, there's the dreaded quilt is desired, which I hate to see, but she does tell you how that particular quilt was quilted, so you do have some idea of what you might want to do when you go to quilt your project. Then she has this red balloon quilt. Now, I had to laugh about this particular one. Let me show you what it looks like in its entirety, because I'm a Stephen King fan. And if you're a Stephen King fan, you know that in the book It, in the movie It, when you see the red balloon, that's a problem, because that's when the monster, what they call It, is around. So when I saw this with the red balloon, I kind of had to laugh. But it is a very effective quilt. You've got some applique going on there. You've got the background, of course, which looks like courthouse steps as well. And I should actually say here, when you're doing this, the balloon itself, it's hard to see here. Let me see if you can see back here, maybe. A little bit easier. You can see the balloon itself is actually made of piece square. So it's not just an applique of solid fabric. It's actually pieced squares first, and then you're making the applique out of it. So you can see that the designs in the book are all quite different from one another, but they're all fairly easy to make. This one here is called Under My Umbrella. And again, you have all the different diagrams to show you how to make it. So that's really helpful. This one's a little bit different when you're making it, maybe a little bit more difficult than something you may have started or tried before, I should say, but not something you can't make. And here's what it looks like at the end. So it does really look like umbrellas, doesn't it? I thought it was quite cute. Then we have one called Sparkling Diamonds, and this is actually paper pieced as well. So you can see what the layout is of it. So you can see that it's got this color kind of radiating out. So color placement, very important in this particular quilt to get that desired effect. So here's the foundation paper piecing templates, and there is the quilt in its entirety in the fabric, so you can see what it looks like. So you really get this glow from this, the orange center and then the yellow around here before you branch out to the darker fabrics. Really effective in this particular quilt. Then she has one called Scrappy Trees Quilt, and this is totally different again. Totally different look. So you have backgrounds going together, and then you're making these little appliques that are going to go on to make those scrappy little trees. So I was really intrigued by this. And she shows you how you're starting with the off center, and then you have the different colors. Now again, we're going from a yellow to an orange, and then we're going to greens and darker greens. So color placement, very effective in this particular quilt. And when you see the final result here, you can see all the different backgrounds she's put together with the thin sashing in between. And then you've got the little trees on top, even the little stems or trunks of the trees, I guess they'd be if they're trees, is in different fabrics too. So very cute, kind of a little modern quilt, I guess, this little one. Very cute. Now we get to a more traditional looking quilt called Festive Stars. Now this one uses polka dots for the background, the black fabric, I guess, with white polka dots, and then the cornerstones, you can see that's white with black. Now, you don't have to use polka dots, but it's really effective in this particular quilt, and who doesn't love polka dots? So here you can see what the quilt looks like in the actual fabrics. So very cute, be a cute little table topper, I think. Again, something totally different, the Stormy Sea wall hang. So here we are with a smaller project. First off, wall hang, a lot of different fabrics going on in here and a lot of different quilting to make it effective. Again, she shows you how you're going to cut those random wavy lines that you're seeing there and how you're putting the entire project together. It also has a different way of finishing it, so there's instructions on how to do that. Now, I thought this particular quilt called the Planets Mini Quilt was really cute and very effective too. I like circles in designs actually, so this one really spoke to me. So you can see what it looks like here. It's all just circles, but you've got different sizes of circles. So you've got all these different appliques. So it's a really fun project to show off some of those fabrics you really like and you want to see all the time. Another project in the book is called the Cowboy Lap Quilt. And I like the name of it because, you know, I live in Western Canada and cowboy country. So the reason she calls it this, because when you look at it, you'd wonder, where did you get that name from? It's the fabrics she's used in it, of course, which are Western themed. So again, you've got circle designs, but this time we're talking piecing, so circular piecing. So if you haven't tried that, putting these circular pieces together, this would be a good project to try because it's not huge and you don't have, you know, you have to do what, 1, 2, 3, 4, I have to add up here, 16, I guess, of these pieced circles together, but you're using different fabric in each of them. Again, what makes this quilt very effective is the contrast between the background and the part of the circle. So you want to make sure there's a contrast there so that those circles are going to pop for you. So I really like the different designs in this book because they're not all the same. Like I said, there's foundation paper piecing, there's regular piecing, there's applique in them, but they're all fairly quick to make, but there are some different techniques in here. So if you haven't tried foundation paper piecing before, or you haven't tried curve piecing before, you'll find some projects in there that will allow you to do that in projects that are quite easy to do. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video.